Maho Hill stands overlooking Taveta Town. When the British landed in the 1890s and later Germans in 1914, they noted the strategic importance of Maho. The Church Missionary Society set up a church and a printing press on the hill. The first newspaper in East and Central Africa, the Taveta Chronicles, was born. And Reverend Remington Stegall took up writing for the paper from 1895 to 1902.
Na katika miaka hiyo, Taveta Chronicle ililipomalizika mwaka wa 1902, 1902, ndio ilibadilika kutoka Taveta Chronicle ikaja the Standard.
Today, Maho Hill has been slashed into two by the tarmac road running from Voi, and much of the printing equipment on the hill is gone. But we came across an old Burlock typewriter made in Nottingham, England. However, its date of manufacture falls between 1914 and 1920, not the period the Taveta Chronicles was in production. 70-year-old Ray Mnene's forefathers were witness to the happenings here.
Germans took over Taveta. They took over for 2 years. It became under Taveta, under the military, German military, and it was ruled from Moshi, which is 50 kilometers away.
And back to Reverend Stegall, it is reported that he was so heartbroken that he left Taveta after his wife, Dora Grace Stegall, died in August 1904. You can spot her grave, among others, at a community cemetery just outside Taveta town. This bougainvillea thicket in the midst of the graveyard sits at the exact spot Stegall's first church stood. Again, Taveta still has another curiosity. A hollow baobab tree at Mbuyuni area, said to be at least 450 years old, but has some legendary connection to the action during World War I. I poke my nose into the affairs of the baobab's hollow to investigate. Inside the hollow, we spot an owl.
Legend from World War I accounts has it that there's a German lady who lost her husband to the war, and as a means of seeking revenge, she took to sitting inside this baobab tree like a sniper and shooting at British soldiers.
And from that point, she just picked up one after the other, the military, especially British military personnel who were coming, moving in convoys. But again, if you look at the baobab, there's some truth about it, because you'll see shot pots of bullets that were exchanged during this area. And when we are starting this program, we actually did find some cartridges around this place.
While the Taveta area is relatively drier than the more easterly Voi and Taita hills, some stakeholders in the tour and conservation circles are, however, worried that the entire Savo circuit, known for wildlife and tourism, is getting drier by the day.
Sighting of Voi as a center, a logistical center of World War I, was because of the resources that were available in Voi at that time. A natural flowing river, so there was access of water. And 100 years on, as we celebrate and commemorate the 100 years to the end of the war, that river no longer flows. It's very seasonal. And that is like our leading light, telling you about the challenges that the environment is going through.
At the moment, stakeholders are planning on an awareness event dubbed the Savo Run to highlight on the plight of the Savo landscape, all its curiosities and treasures. Mark Namaswa, KTN News.
The National Assembly will on Wednesday take a critical